so it's going to stop the flow, and you're going to trap. You're still going to trap a bubble in here. So to eliminate.
Which way is up in this? Up is that way. Okay.
This is how he's going to do this. So to eliminate that, I take some of my wax. And I'm doing this while it's still, you can see it's still gooey. I can cut it real easily. If I, pass that around. It's warm.
Oh, yeah.
I just cast that. Not long ago. If you do this with cold wax, you spend a lot more time trying to manipulate it. So, what I want to do is... I want this to be super thin. This doesn't need, this is gonna fill with glass, but if I keep it, you know, that thickness, then that's excessive amount of cold working that I don't want to do at the very end, right? So what I did is while it's still hot, I just thinned it out. So it's about 1/16 of an inch, okay? All that is just enough to allow the air the flow. I just fill that in. So now what'll happen is the glass will flow down and the air can travel up right there. And then all I've got to do is just a little bit of Dremel work right there to remove that guy off my glass chunk.
Do you just have it connected on the arm?
Yeah.
Just point on the arm?
Yep. So I'm actually going to fill this in a little bit more.
Is there a hole in that, or is it just solid? Why does it make the air bubble?
Why does it what?
I'm not following.
Because when you make the next
mold, it'll have
create a
so when the glass flows down,
yeah,
now the air can flow back out of the casting. The air can, if an air bubble gets trapped in his fist,
yeah,
this is where it can escape.
Yeah.
But it's not escaping from, I think that's where you're
confused.
It's not escaping from that particular wax.
Right. This is just for glass. Just for the glass. I'm preliminary.
I for a moment was forgetting that this is the shape of the glass. Right. And I was thinking of it filling inside the other. Gotcha. I'm there now. It took me a...
You said you do this in a different order. If it was bronze, do you do it? You would add the wax afterwards or something?
Yes. Because in bronze work, I just always add the gates right before ceramic shell. So, I gotta make sure he's attached really well. So, I'll get out.
So this is dude is the equivalent of your plate.
Yep. Yep. This is
ding. Okay.
Yep. Thank you. now all I want to do is make sure that that's attached real well. I'm just dripping it on. To make sure it's attached. Ooh, there's a lot of wax on that already. Sorry. And then, so because I dripped that on, it's a little kind of cruddy in there. So I just want to clean that up. And what I'm thinking about right now is just my cold working. I'm trying to minimize this to minimize my cold working. I'm gonna do that to his head as well, just because I'll feel actually I think that'll feel. You have a question?
No.
Oh, I thought you knew. I think that's about the only spot I really need to consider. That kind of goes down. I think I'm good to go. As long as I vent the ball, the head.
Oh, so you were thinking that because of the narrowness of the neck?
I was thinking that because it funnels down here, that I might want to do that again right here.
Oh,
okay.
Which would...
Would have a higher success rate?
Yes.
So...
That's really loose.
So, just fix that. That's all it took to reattach that, was just to get it gooey again. Okay?
It's a lot stickier than jeweler's wax. It's a lot stickier than jeweler's wax.
When I do this at my own studio, I actually don't use the regular wax, I use sticky wax.
Stinky?
Sticky.
Oh, sticky. Okay.
There's a specific type of wax. It's a very high microcrystalline wax. It's called sticky wax. It was formulated for sprueing purposes for bronze work. So if you had to attach a big sprue to a side of a bronze leg,
mm-hmm.
you just take the sprue, dip it in the sticky wax, and just stick it on, and it instantly, it just adheres. I don't mind a little bit of cold working. I would rather have a good casting than to have a wasted casting. I would rather do a little bit of cold working and get rid of these than have to remake an entire mold.
Yeah.
So.
So when you do the cold work, you can put in all those lines and details, with like the pen thing?
The Dremel?
Yeah.
Yep. Exactly what I'll do. So because this is still warm, I'm really able to manipulate it real easily without difficulty. That's why I said make sure that you have your stuff going, and you pour your slab right before. And if I don't use this, I can leave this for more people to do sprues, or I can just toss it back into the wax and reuse it. So how was everybody's week? I know this is real exciting stuff.
Busy.
But the way I teach is not so much, I'm more concerned with you guys learning the process and being able to duplicate the process than I am you guys walking away with one big massive casting, if that makes sense.
Yeah.
I want you guys to be able to walk away and come back and rent the studio and do this on your own. Having said that, after Steve's class, would you have felt comfortable?
Had I come right back, I probably would have come. But I didn't, so here I am again. which would probably be a good thing. Now, I went online and looked at the, what was it, Complete Sculptor? And did I see, can you buy ready-made sprues that are just like...
Yes, but they're 3/8 of an inch around.
Oh, okay.
They're monstrous. They're, yes.
Okay.
Technically, in terms of Complete Sculptor, a gate is a square with a hollow tube in it, and a sprue is a 3/8 inch rod. Now, that's not to say you can't go to McCaw's here down on Madison
yes.
Avenue
mm-hmm.
and get this size sprue, and get jeweler's sprue.
Mm-hmm.
So that's how I made this whole thing.
Yeah.
I was just looking at how you're struggling to put that on, and I'm sitting there thinking, he's having trouble.
No.
I'm never going to be able to do that.
It's just taking time. I mean, that's all it is just relaxing and taking time. And the more time you spend doing this, the less time you'll spend trying to fix your glass. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
Not so much that I'm struggling, I'm just kind of taking my time. And this one doesn't really want to stick, so I'm going to add a little bit of goo to him.
You're in such a confined spot right now.
It's as simple as got a little puddle, and it doesn't need to be that hot because this is boiling. If your wax is smoking, that's boiling. There. That's all it took.
And you're not touching the metal onto the piece, right?
No,
you're
not
just
at all.
Dripping it off.
Yep.
Yep, basically I just drip the wax.
If you
right
touch
into
it, you just vaporize it.
So you want to look at what I did. Grab him by his butt. Grab him like I'm grabbing, or just like that. Don't, because his head might still be a little